Many of you already know about Windows God Mode, the nickname for that special folder you can create by creating a folder and then naming it this weird code looking thing. And then it has a whole bunch, basically all the settings in Control Panel in one place. But that is not the only special type of folder you can create using special names as a folder. So that's what we're gonna go over today, what the deal is with these and what other ones there might be, how they even work. And actually there's probably like around 100 of them that I've found. Now these special folders don't exactly have any kind of special name as far as I found. There is a Microsoft article that refers to the technique as using file system folders as junction points, which isn't exactly a user-friendly name. Now, file system folder is just a folder, and then a junction point is kind of like an advanced type of shortcut you can think of it as. If you want the detailed explanation, you can watch my other video I made about super shortcuts, symbolic links, that type of thing, for more details. So let me actually explain where these special codes come from and why they direct to where they do and where you can actually find them. You see, most menus, I think all menus actually in Windows, have an associated CLSID, it's called. It's basically just kind of a reference number that is used internally. And you can actually find these in the Windows registry under /hkclasses/root/CLSID. And then all the folders in here, they're actually keys, but they have folder icons. And all of these in the brackets are CLSIDs. Now, to be clear, not all of these are for some kind of special menu or folder or anything. All of these are for different Windows application components, they're called, just like little functional bits of Windows. So for example, there's one in here that is called Microsoft Move To Service. So I guess that's the thing that would be called when you try to move an object. There's also Sort By Column Explorer command. So I guess when you go to sort a column, this thing gets called. And of course, these both have CLSIDs along with anything else in here that does random stuff. But also it contains those menus and folders that are actually accessible through Windows Explorer, such as the God Mode one. And for those that are actually accessible through File Explorer, if you want to create a shortcut to it, what you do is you take that CLSID and then create a new folder, put a period in front of it, and then paste the CLSID. You can put anything you want in front of the period, it really doesn't matter, but as long as it's period and then all that code, and then it will create a shortcut to that location. And we can even do a search for the one that is for the so-called God Mode, and there it is in the CLSID registry keys, along with all the other stuff. One thing to note though, is that when you go to create one of these special shortcuts, the name you give it before the period won't actually show up. It used to in older versions, but it won't now. The icon will just be blank. If you do want to name it, you can do that differently, but you have to use it with a shortcut. So to do that, just right click wherever, hit create shortcut. And then for the target, what you do is you put explorer and then space and then shell and then three colons and then whatever CLSID again. And there has to be the three colons there. And then it will ask you next what you want to name it, and then that will actually show and go to the same place. Unfortunately, this way it just shows the default File Explorer icon, but you can go and manually change the icon if you want. So out of all of these, how can you actually tell which ones are for a menu you can access? And I actually found a couple different types of special CLSIDs. Not all of them are in here. There's another one I'll get to next. So one of the types of the shortcuts in here are for system applications, I guess they're called. So what you can actually do is look for any of the CLSIDs that has a subkey that says system.applicationName. And from what I have gathered, all of those do access some kind of special menu. And there's also other ways that I found. For example, I believe all the ones that are actually accessible also have a subkey called shell folders. However, not all the ones that have shell folders are accessible, so it's kind of like a square rectangle situation. So for those, it's more of a trial and error type thing. However, there is another type of special folder shortcut thing called shell folders that I can go over. They work a little bit differently. Now, speaking of stuff that's special and cool though, before we continue, let me tell you about today's sponsor, Mine. Mine lets you find out which companies have your data and lets you control where you do or don't want to keep it. You start out by going to saymine.com and just sign in with your email account you want to analyze and give it a minute to do its thing. Mine will only analyze the subject line and sender of the email, plus some metadata to figure out which companies you've interacted with. But as their privacy policy states, they don't collect any of the content of your email for analysis. So then when it's done, it shows you the results. For me, there are over 250 companies that have data on me. Not exactly ideal, if you ask me. On the My Footprint page, you can see a selection of these companies, but I can gather up the courage to look through the entire list, which I assure you is eye-opening. By clicking on a company, it shows me, for example, that EA stores info like my financial and identity data, as well as online behavior, in addition to having a somewhat elevated exposure risk. Here's another company that I barely remember signing up for, but never ended up using, and I don't really want them having my data. So I can just click reclaim and it will compose an email that will be sent directly from my inbox to the company. And this is important because companies generally only honor requests coming directly from the person. Then after you allow it to send the email, you can track and review your requests and cancel it within an hour if you change your mind. And since privacy is important for businesses too, Mind has created a solution for companies to help manage their own privacy operations. And that includes automation of handling requests from consumers. So if you want to start reclaiming your own data, be sure to visit saymind.com now and sign up. I'll also put that link in the description. And with all that being said, let's continue. All right, so like I said before, there are also other types of shortcuts called shell folders. And I came across these because the CLSID ones kind of get mixed up in these. A lot of people call them the same thing, but I don't think they really are. Basically, these shell folders shortcuts are going to go to some specific actual location, not like a menu, and all of them have the format where you put shell, colon, and then the name of the thing, and then it goes to that location. And where you use this is either in the run dialog box, or you can also create an actual just shortcut. You can put it in there, and I'll explain how to do that more in detail. But one example is if you go into run and do shell startup, that opens up the folder that gets run automatically. You can put stuff in there if you want it to start up with Windows. Another one is shell app data. That goes to the app data folder. And if instead you want to create a regular clickable shortcut, then what you do is click new shortcut and then type in as the target explorer and then space and then the same shell whatever. So with these shell folder icons where you put the name, you only put one colon, not three like you did before. That's only if you're putting the raw CLSID. Now, like I mentioned, all of these seem to go to an actual folder location, so they are more like regular shortcuts, but they're more useful, I think, for just not having to remember where these things are. I don't really want to have a shortcut taking up space on my desktop that goes to the startup folder because I almost never access it. But if I do, then instead of trying to remember where it is or looking it up, I can simply go type shell startup and it takes me right to it. Now with a lot of them like app data, there's also the percent app data percent shortcut. That's a different thing. That's an environment variable. I'm not going to get into those. They're different. Now, I know what you're probably thinking. All right, great. But how do I actually like get a list of all of these? Well, instead of actually digging through the registry like I did, there's actually a way easier way, which is to use a free program called WinArrowTweaker. And this program, I've used it for a while. It's awesome. It does a whole bunch of other stuff besides just what I'm going to show you, but this is relevant for the video. Basically, if you go down to one of the menus, it has a thing called Shell Folder CLSID Shortcut. And this basically shows you all of these special menus you can create folders for using the CLSID, except you don't actually have to look at the CLSID and it'll actually show you for most of them, the name of what it actually goes to. And it seems to do this automatically. It's not just a pre-made list because I have some for like Dropbox, Creative Cloud that definitely were not pre-installed with Windows and they're still in here. Now, one thing to take note is even in this list, not all of them may be usable and go to an actual menu that can be opened in Windows Explorer. Some of them might just be for behind the scenes, so it'll either do nothing or it'll say some kind of error when you try to open them, although most of these do actually work. And look, you can even find God mode in here. The actual name here is all tasks. However, another important thing I want to point out is all of those shell colon shortcuts don't actually show up in this WinArrowTweaker. It doesn't have those. It only has the CLSID ones. So if you want a list of those, what I actually did is just created a Google Doc with a spreadsheet, and I'll put the link in the description so you can access that if you want. And in there, you can see I put all these shell shortcuts, at least in Windows 11, which is what I'm using. If you're using an older version, you're watching in the future, they might be a bit different. I also added two other tabs with some raw data for the CLSID info that I copied out of the registry. If you want to look through that, you can just read the little descriptions I wrote on those tabs. Again, those are just extra, they're not necessary. It's way easier to just get it through WinArrowTweaker. So now you know, if you ever wondered what the real deal was with that God mode folder everyone called it, or if you were wondering if there were any other locations you could create such things for, now you can. Thanks again to Mind for sponsoring this video. Be sure to visit saymind.com so you can start reclaiming your data too. The link is also in the description. If you guys want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is the one I mentioned before, talking about super shortcuts and symbolic links, they're called, in Windows. They're definitely really useful and not many people know about them, so I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Let me know what you think down in the comments. Give the video a like, all that good stuff, and I'll see you in the next one.